Rababazi bakata di bazuka di babu zandali makuja badi bakadi masi badi makadi babu sakaya rababazi kali bazu se katiri mabu ribabazi kali babu zandili makadi mabu zabaya ribabazi kantili moza veka dili mamu zabali baba baba ya babu zambe zakili babu zaba ribabazi kantili makadi li mazu sadili makaya rababaza baba 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 bazidala baba baba zabaya rab Zidele makadi zaburi baba zabaya bazi bana baba rabazi baba bakandele baka baka ba. I am excited this morning. Makada la baka baka di zala baka ya rababa. I want you to be excited this morning. I want you to lift up your voice and blast in tongues. I want you to pray. Mazi kata la baka na. I want you to stir your spirit up. Makasa kaka na. I want you to declare some things into the heavens. Makada kaba for your Jesus is alive, for your master is alive. Rabba. Those who didn't believe that he would die and resurrect, Rabba's prophecy has been fulfilled. Death was not able to hold him captive. He can remain in the grave for the third day, Rabazaka Bakabakanda, because he said on the third day he will resurrect. I came to you this morning with a good news that he has resurrected. He has resurrected. He was crucified on Friday. He was in the grave on Saturday. Rabba Shaka. But Sunday, oh glory be to God. Our Jesus. Death was not able to hold him up. In the name of Jesus. Bible made us to understand in Matthew chapter 28, verse 1 to 8. And Mark also, chapter 16, verse 1 to 8. That hey, Mary Magdalene and Mary and those who were accompanying them, hey, went to the sepulchre. They went to the sepulchre. But hey, in verse 5 and verse 6, Bible says, and the angel answered and said unto the woman, fear not, for he, I know that he seek Jesus, which was crucified. Matthew chapter 28, verse 5, which was crucified. Jesus, who was crucified, Rabba Shaka. But verse 6, he said, he is not here, for he is risen. Beloved, this is the good news for us. He is risen. Jesus is risen. Our Jesus is not in the grave. He's risen. He is risen. And what the angel told them to do is that they should go and tell the disciples. Go and tell them. Go and broadcast the news. Go and tell everybody that the one who was crucified, he is what? Risen. Glory, hallelujah. This morning, by the power of God, if you are dead, if there's something wrong with your life, if you are crucified, I come to you this morning that you are rising up in the name of Jesus. Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 11, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. Our mortal bodies need to be quickened by the spirit. By the spirit, that same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, that same spirit that dwells in you shall quicken. I pray for quickening. I pray for stirring. I am asking that any dead thing in your life, if your business is dead, if your marriage is dead, if your children are dead, the academics, whatever, if your ministry is dead, if there's nothing working around, if there's nothing working for you, I declare and decree the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, the same spirit that conquered death and brought Jesus out, let that same spirit work something in you in the name of Jesus. I call for your revival. I call for your stirring. I call for your lifting up in the name of Jesus. Bible has made us to understand in Acts chapter 2 verse 24 that whom God has raised up having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be holding of it. It was not possible for Jesus to remain in the grave. I declare to you, it is not possible for you to be in your sins. It is not possible for you to be in your poverty. It is not possible for you to be in your unemployment. It is not possible for you to be in your lack of activity. Things must happen in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The same spirit that raised up Jesus is working in you today in the mighty name of Jesus. Bible says in John chapter 5 verse 21, for as the Father raised up the dead and quickened them, even so the Son quickened whom he will. I come to you this morning letting you to know that Jesus is willing. Jesus, who has resurrected from the dead, is willing to quicken you in the name of Jesus. Glorious hallelujah. Oh, we thank God that he's risen. He's risen by the Spirit. Let the Spirit of God that raised Jesus dwell in your mortal body. Let it do something amazing in your life. Resurrection Sunday. As we remember the resurrection of Jesus, I am asking that let every good thing in your life be resurrected in the name of Jesus. Beloved, we are not dead, we are alive. We are not weak, we are strong. We are not sick, we are healed. God is doing something new in our life, and we give him glory, praise, and honor in the name of Jesus. I want you to celebrate God this morning. I want you to be happy. I want you to go all out, you know, and just call upon God the more, receive more oil, and let everybody know that your Jesus is alive. He's risen, and you are also alive. I give God the praise, glory for your life. I will come your way again. It is our time. It is our moment to let all the world know that our Jesus is alive. Resurrection Sunday. Oh, glory be to God in the highest. Somebody be excited. Your Jesus is no more in the grave. For the grave was not able to hold him. For death was not able to hold him captive. This is your servant, Chris Mensah, coming your way this morning. Hallelujah. Bye-bye.